Morning, y'all. It's so early in the morning. It's not even 6 o'clock yet. I just got on here to tell y'all the bitch is tired. I don't want to do nothing else today. I'm looking at myself, talking to y'all. My eyes got dark circles around them. Like, Jesus, be an entire face mask. Like, I'm tired. So the reason I decided to do one early this morning is because I was just sitting here thinking about what it is to be a mom, and that's being with a spouse, without a spouse, with a mate, without a mate. Like, it's really tough work. So we have 7 kids in our house: a 17-year-old, a 16-year-old, 2 9-year-olds, a 5-year-old, a 4-year-old, and a 2-year-old. Well, let me tell you, I'm tired, right? So I get up early every morning. Usually dad has to be at work at like 5 o'clock in the morning. So I get up and get everybody up and start helping them get it together. By the time they leave, even if I don't have to work, I'm still like up, like I can't go back to sleep. So I try to do something productive. Like, I try to clean a little bit, do some errands, make some phone calls, etc., right? And then even if I don't have to go to my day job, 9 times out of 10, I probably have to go to my afternoon job. So that's still a struggle, right? I said all that to say that moms, it's okay to be fucking tired. It's okay to tell your children or your baby father, your spouse, your mate, whatever. It's okay to tell them no. It is not okay to take on more than you can chew. It is not okay to do everything for them. Like, that's a lesson I'm actually learning myself. And what sucks about me learning this lesson is because of my mental issues, I tend to express this in all types of fucked up ways. Like, let me tell you, God sent the imperfect, perfect man for me because that man got patience of a saint that I will never, ever, 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 ever have because I have 7 kids. So I will never have that patience again, right? Anyway, I just want you guys to know, as moms, as single dads, single moms, whatever type of parent you are, it's okay to take a mental and a physical break from your responsibilities. It doesn't make you a bad person. I'm really talking to moms more than anything because it's a stigma that we as moms have to continue to do our momly duties or our wifely duties, spouse duties, whatever, with a smile on our face. And bitch, I'm not smiling if I ain't fucking happy. That shit will literally kill you. Like, putting a smile on your face to make your kids or your spouse mate happy is one of the biggest sacrifices we make as women because it lets everyone feel like life is okay for you. And then when you finally have a mental breakdown, they looking at you like they can't understand why. And the reason why is because we keep smiling when we need to be cursing these motherfuckers the fuck out. No, motherfucker, I'm not doing it for you. You are more than capable. And that's what I'm finna start doing from now on. Like, y'all, I'm fucking tired. More than anything, I am emotionally tired. I'm about to start telling all these people in this house, no. Oh, you wanna go somewhere? You better catch that bus. You got a JOB. Oh, you wanna go somewhere? No, I'm not taking you. You better catch an Uber. But if you, I mean, y'all, like, I'm about to start telling them no. They in for a long summer if they don't learn how to catch this damn bus. And I'm mad at myself because when I was a teenager, I damn sure was catching the bus. And I didn't even feel embarrassed about it. I actually felt a sense of like freedom to be able to do something I wanted to do without my parents having to do it for me. I'm finna make these two oldest teenagers of mine become unbougie. I don't even know how they bougie in the first place, y'all, because we poor. So I don't know how they feel entitled that mommy is gonna crank up this car every single time they want to go somewhere. They finna learn real life lessons. And I know y'all probably thinking like, okay, they 16 to 17, they should have learned them. Let me tell y'all something, better late than never, god damn it. And they finna learn how to catch this bus just like they learn how to open a bank account, just like they learn how to do everything else, just like they make A's and B's in school. They can make their fucking feet walk to the damn bus stop. Do you understand? Like, I don't mind doing it, and it's okay, moms. Like, we don't have to mind doing it, but we need to mind how often we do it. We need to mind how many sacrifices we make. And not saying that our kids or our spouses won't sacrifice for us. It's just at the end of the day, We push these kids out. We help them grow up. And to a degree, we do that for our spouses as well. And it's time, God damn it, for us to be like, you know what? I'm tired. I've been doing this shit. For me, I feel like I've been doing this shit. My oldest will be 18 in December. A bitch is fucking tired, okay? And if it will be technical, because women, we do raise these men like fools, but we do it. I've been messing with this current husband of mine since I was 15, 16 years old, y'all. A bitch will be 37 next month. I'm tired. Do you understand? I'm not doing it no more. I'm exhausted. Look at my eyes. Like, it's black circles around them. Like, Jesus, be a complete face mask. Y'all, you know, just being honest and jokes and stuff. But in all actuality, like, women, we got to do better taking care of ourselves. And until we do that, we should not be able to take on the whole world. Y'all have a good day.